Alan Ochanda, KTN News in Siaya.
The ghost of August 15, 2022 came alive during the burial of the late Chief of Defense Forces, General Francis Ogolla, in his home in Siaya County. As the CS for Defense, Aiden Duale, defended Ogolla of any wrongdoing, saying that he was pushed by his superiors to go to Bomas to try and force a runoff in the 2022 presidential elections race. Now, as KTN's political affairs reporter Emmanuel To now explains, Duale disclosed that President William Ruto has directed that no juniors will sit in for their superiors in the powerful National Security Advisory Committee going forward.
Close to 2 years since the heated and tension-filled action at the Bomas of Kenya on August 15, 2022, with allegations that a delegation from the powerful National Security Advisory Committee had visited the venue to try and force a runoff in the closely contested presidential race. During the burial of General Ogolla, Defense CS Aiden Duale in Ngia Alego in Siaya County revealed details of how the late chief of the Kenya Defense Forces was hoodwinked into an alleged plot to interfere with the outcome of the 2022 presidential election.
General Ogolla, as a respectable soldier and general, he asked and sent a text message to his bosses and asked, "What am I going to do in Bomas?" And this has happened. And General Ogolla was told, "It's been decided, you go."
Duale stated that powerful individuals had told the vice CDF then that he was only going to avert a possible security situation, only to find himself in the middle of the murky political waters.
And the 411 came while he was in Bomas, saying the results will be announced at 3. And General Ogolla then again sent a text message and saying, "Now that the result will be announced at 3, as a general, as a soldier, what am I doing here?" And he was told, "Stay with your colleague." That text message is there.
Duale detailing a string of text messages between Robert Kiboshi, who was the then CDF, and General Ogolla, including one where he told his boss that, quote, "Sir, this is not about security but about politics." Duale saying that some members of NSAC had tried to untwist the late CDF.
Honorable Raila Odinga was very right, and I came today to qualify his statement that General Ogolla, a man he knows, would not have gone to Bomas. And the people who sent him to Bomas, some of them are here. Some of the people who sent him to Bomas, some of the people who sent him to Bomas are known.
Duale adding that going forward, the president has directed that members of the powerful organ should not delegate their duties to their juniors to sit in the committee.
Tomorrow, another member of the National Security Committee will commit the same crime.
The revelations come a day after the Azimio leader Raila Odinga distanced Ogolla from any wrongdoing in the 2022 polls.
General Ogolla would never have contemplated or thought about going to Bomas of Kenya to force Mr. Chebukati to alter the results of last general elections. So if you want this to be removed, I will lay him to rest.
And with his death, the family hopes that the ghost of August 15, 2022, that smeared mud on his illustrious career will be put to rest and that his track record as a dedicated and outstanding leader is upheld. Emmanuel To, KTN News, Nairobi.
May the general's soul rest.